when I get to the rainforest every year and I just see frogs again for the first time, it just brings me joy like no other thing. And then knowing that we do work that can help conserve them for the future is really important to me as well.
Frogs all across the world are in a lot of trouble. Species are going extinct at alarming rates.
The chytrid fungus is a pathogen of, you know, large conservation concern because it's been linked to population declines and extinctions of amphibians globally.
And all of these threats are made even worse by climate change.
Atualmente, as mudanças climáticas aqui na área, ela é bem visível. Olha, a seca mais definida que nós tivemos aqui foi em 2005, né? 2004, 2005.
Chytrid is a waterborne pathogen. So our hypothesis was that with a drought, amphibians aggregate near water bodies, and thus there's more transmission of chytrid.
É a compreensão dessas doenças e da forma como elas se propagam. E isso tem, obviamente, uma importância na conservação desses animais.
In this project, we are focusing on three unique tropical amphibian communities here in Brazil, in Peru, and also in Cameroon. And all three of these amphibian communities have species that have a tadpole life stage and species that are direct developers, where the juvenile frogs hatch directly from the egg. And they don't have very much direct contact with water. Species that have direct development should be less likely to encounter this fungus and less likely to become infected. But when those frogs do become infected with the fungus, they're very susceptible, and they've noticed big die-off events in these direct developing species. And so that sort of raised the alarm that we need to broaden our focus.
We have microbiologists, herpetologists, modelers, we have people in the lab, we have people in the field.
É uma das melhores partes, né? Porque quando a gente trabalha com diferentes grupos, a gente aprende o tempo todo com todo mundo.
When you study frogs, you spend a lot of time walking around in the forest at night. Frogs, for the most part, are nocturnal. We spend a lot of time shining our headlamps, looking for frogs in the trees, in the bushes, on the ground.
We put a cotton swab on their skin to test for the fungus, and then we release all the frogs. And then we repeat this every other month for 2 years because we're really interested in the seasonal variation.
We also have enclosures in the field. Half of the enclosures receive normal rainfall, and the other half of the enclosures have a rainfall shelter to simulate drought. So with that experiment, we hope to test whether movement patterns will change in response to drought, and how that in turn will impact transmission of chytrid.
The goal is to put all of this data together into a model so that we can predict how we think these different communities will respond and be able to take action.
One of the main findings is what we expected. Frogs are aggregating near water bodies in response to drought. But now we are starting to analyze skin swabs, seeing whether or not the aggregation resulted in increased transmission.
One of the other things that we've been noticing is some individuals will be infected and then clear the infection by themselves. It suggests that they have the ability to recover from infection in a natural setting. And I think it really demonstrates the resilience of amphibians. They've been on this planet for hundreds of millions of years, and they've faced other periods of climate change. And so what I hope that this research can help us understand is what are the ingredients that they need to be able to make it through the current challenges so that frogs can continue to be successful parts of our community here on the planet.